mentor, played by actor Michael K. Williams. You may have noticed him on The Wire or Boardwalk Empire, and we had the honor of catching up with him during his 2K21 mocap session. Take a look.
You show some upside, but you still gotta step it up.
I can still play.
Just like your old man. Play through it all.
Continues to elevate his play every year. He said, it's just putting in hard work. I take this game very seriously. I love the game of basketball. I don't count myself out. No matter what the score is, who we're playing, I'm going full tilt. Kevin, back to you.
Special talent indeed. David, thank you. Right, we've got two terrific highlight-making teams, both athletic in so many ways.
You know, it makes me harken all the way back to college. And one of my teammates, Stacy Ogden, one of the greatest athletes I ever played alongside. But we're going to see a lot of his impact in tonight's game.
And now the opening lineup for Phoenix. Sharich and Ayton at the four in the front. Rubio and Booker, they're the backcourt. And it's Oubre in at the small forward position. And for Charlotte, Washington and Zeller are in the middle. Tim Hardaway Jr. out there with Jr., and it's Batum in at the first spot. And finish off by Oubre.
Well, Ricky Rubio has defined point guard vision. He can see the floor so beautifully.
Inside, Jr., good for the basket, starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
It seems like Gatorade has had a huge NBA star be the spokesman forever now. They announced that Junior will be the basketball rep for Gatorade heading forward.
Guys like Paul George and D-Wade, they've all worked with Gatorade. They feel that Junior can reach that kind of level of superstar status. And the top five Booker.
Well, DeAndre Ayton is a team-first guy, and boy, does he set up the open man.
Here's the Hornets with the ball.
I mean, it's such an easy release for Devin Booker. Doesn't have to elevate that much to get that shot off.
And what that means, Greg, is that smooth score translates into the three-point shootout. Booker with the all-time record, 28 points in a round. That leads to a victory in 2018 in that contest. That was special.
And here's Rubio. After Tim Hardaway made that last three-pointer.
Get the result of that shot. They'll take that whenever they get it.
And they should, because it's when you start tuning down that kind of look that your offense can start to bog down a bit.
Now here's Hardaway. Elliott Bray unable to get his last shot to go. Out of bounds, and they go to the Suns. The Suns have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Rubio, the pass to Oubre. Good ball movement here by the Suns. Rubio outside. Puts one up. And the call on the shot sends him to the line. It's going to be on Junior.
This is one of the most talked about international players ever. And I think Rubio just needs to stay healthy and keep working on that shot.
The Suns shooting their first free throws of this team.
You've got to appreciate their ability to make free throws. 81% as a team.
And that one falls for Ricky Rubio. And so Ricky Rubio nails both of them.
An efficient night from the line. This is a guy who puts in the work and it pays dividends.
Hardaway passes to Junior. Outside Hardaway. His second shot goes in off to a good start, 2-for-2.
Well, Tim Hardaway Jr. getting stronger, and that's a problem when he's trying to finish through contact.
So it's Rubio bringing it up for Phoenix. They trail by one. Pass it to Sharich. Booker with it. A three. Cruise it from outside. Booker's got 5 points so far.
Good way to start this game. You want to get him rolling as early as possible.
He's a guy, if he gets hot, he can carry your offense for long stretches.
Now here's Hardaway. 5 points in the game. Here's Junior. And five on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And not backing down from the physical defense. Junior embraces taking on these challenges.
Charlotte shooting their first free throws of the game right now.
And team free throw numbers really about as good as you could ask for. Around 80% on the season.
And the first one drops. Both shots good from the front.
What I love about Junior, he's got grit and tenacity. He's always looking for ways to improve.
Johnson outside. About 3 minutes gone here on the first quarter. And stolen by Junior. Pass to Rozier. Kicks it to Junior. And there's the pass to Bridges. Now Rozier. Bucket six. On the arc. Hits the 3-point foul.
Get in the habit of giving him open looks from three. First quarter steal, but not who you want to leave open.
Pass to Boyd. Booker outside. It's up a three. Another three for Phoenix.
How about that? Devin Booker says anything you can do, I can do better. Three in the books.
To the wing on the left. Booker against Bridges. Taken away by Johnson. Fast break, here come the Suns. And that one, good.
And right there, you see Devin Booker's feel for the game. This guy knows exactly when to give it up.
Charlotte trailing. This is it to Bridges. In the corner, it's Junior.
Listen, we know the mid-range game is in this guy's arsenal, but you wonder, should he have moved it just one pass more?
Boy, and the layup's good off the glass. Junior with it. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Milwaukee. Rozier finds Bridges. Back to Rozier. Good, making the perfect 2-for-2 from the floor. And so Booker will bring it up for the Suns. They come into this one following the loss to the Mavericks.
Yeah, I mean, hard time shooting the rock in that one. But they also didn't give themselves the best look.
I think even when you get quality looks, there was an inability to stay consistent. It is hard to win on a cold shooting night in today's NBA. The scoring is just too good.
And so it's Devin Booker making highlights for Phoenix. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. Back to the action after this word. And getting checked in for the Hornets. And here's Sharp. They're on an 18-7 run. Setting the floor for the Suns. Rubio and Booker, they're the backcourt. Johnson is hiking out there with Aaron Baines. And it's Bridges in at the three spot. Here's Junior. Off target there, that would have pushed the lead to double digits. Shots good by Hernan Gomez.
This guy is just working his tail off on the boards. You love the effort, love the energy.
Outside, pass to Johnson, fires the three, it's Biombo with the rebound.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Well, you can just tell how skilled Junior is by the looks he creates for others. Defenses know what this guy can do.
Rubio, the pass to Booker. And here is Johnson. Here's Bridges. He's gotten some minutes. but nothing on the board yet.
Just can't find a shot. It's no wonder they're losing. I mean, he's been combining his skills a lot.
Here's Junior. Phoenix rounds the miss.
Listen, offensively, they're very comfortable with him taking that shot. It's a good look under very little pressure. He just can't convert.
Bridges kicks to Rubio. A three-pointer is right on target. Rubio's got five now.
I tell you, the jumper might not be the prettiest of pictures, but the offensive spacing improves dramatically when Rubio hits it.
Junior the finish to Biombo. And Baines pulls it down. Second left, and it's in after a nice bounce off the right side. Rubio's got it back down to a single digit deficit for Phoenix, and so it's the Charlotte Hornets in the driver's seat, up 8 points at the end of the quarter. They're feeling very confident, shooting the ball with great efficiency and dictating the pace. We come back right after this.
From the first half, he has been very efficient.
I think they've taken their time. They've showed incredible patience. It's a sign of a well-coached ball club.
Washington and Zeller are in the middle. Junior's out there with Hardaway, and it's Batum in at the small forward. So that's who James Borrego starts the second half with. You know, Greg, we know there's some power finishers in the NBA, but he complains a lot that he needs to sell contact rather than muscle through it. Evaluate those kind of power finishers in the game.
Well, I mean, there's still power will always play a role, especially when you can add in quickness and athleticism. I think you start right there with Giannis. I mean, he's kind of epitomizes that. LeBron obviously is still in that category. A guy like Kawhi Leonard, he can send you into the statue when he gets going down the hill as well.
It's good.
Boy, have they been hitting the backboard in this game. Boy, kind of surprising. It's such a tight game.
Phoenix calls timeout. And the Hornets making a change here. Bumps checked it. Is his second to the free throw line in this one.
One of the areas where he has excelled all season long. How about 87% from the line?
Five seconds left to play in the third. so good to have you with us. Suns trail by 7. On the court now for the Suns, getting going here in the fourth. Johnson and Jarvis are the 3 and the 4. Then it's Ricky Rubio. Then it's Aaron Baines. And it's Boyd in at the 2-guard position. Pass to Jarvis. 6 to shoot. The Suns need to get a shot off. And Rubio gets it to go on the assist by Jarvis. Rubio's got the first field goal of the fourth quarter here for the Suns. Now, here's Junior. He dishes it to Bridges. And 2 free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
I tell you, Bridges, you see the athleticism, the improving skill set, and the instincts are coming along.
First one falls for. Mike Kaminsky, he's jumped in for Phoenix. He's perfect from the line this time. Suns trail by 7. Knocked away. Now, here's Rubio. Tight defense on him, and he uses the glass on the way.
Well, the balance that Ricky Rubio has, even under duress, stays calm and finds a way to score.
The kick out to Rozier. Shot clock at 6. Out to the wing. Here's Junior. Unable to get that one. Good D by Rubio.
Well, this has not been his finest hour, but give your teammates some credit for doing the job of stepping in.
It's going to be on Junior.
Those defenders just look a little bit gassed. I mean, they're getting...
fourth quarter.
It comes. That's one of those clutch shots he's known for. When the pressure is high, he seems to be the most locked in.
Now, Junior. There's 21 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's the 2. Here's the pass to Washington. Seconds left in the game. And now, let's present our new guys for the game. Ricky Rubio.
His main goal has been to attack the rim, put the D in some tough spots, and also finish it.
Booker against Hunter.
can see the top.
And I think the defender knows once he gets cooking, look out. The bucket looks awfully big to him right now.
And the Hornets call time here. They're trailing by two. 3 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, what do you think?
They actually could take a three here and cope for the win if they want to. I think they'll try and send it to overtime. The players don't want it in this situation, so you should be able to get a good look inside.
So it's the Suns taking the W in a close one. This win, such a tremendous emotional boost for him.
Really an accomplishment and crazy finish to take a road game like this and simply deflate an entire building.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Doris Burke, David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you later.